So we know that people don't like working for Donald Trump. And very frequently after they get booted out or leave, they write books and we figure out a whole bunch of stuff of what's going on. But there are some who hate working there that are still on the inside. And apparently in the past couple of days, one of those people chose to leak a number of different daily schedules for Donald Trump to Axios, giving us, I would say previously,
like confirming what we thought.
We sort of assumed this was going on, but now we know the actual numbers for what is going on in terms of what he does all day long. So let's get into some details.
Okay.
Each day's schedule places Trump in quote, location, Oval Office from 8 to 11 a.m. That sounds good. But Trump, who often wakes before 6 a.m., is never in the Oval Office during those hours, according to six sources with direct knowledge. They could be wrong, they could be lying, to be fair. But that's what they say, and those are the people he has chosen to surround himself with. They say instead he spends his mornings in the residence watching TV, reading the papers. That implies that they are liars, by the way. And responding to what he sees and reads by phoning aides, members of Congress, friends, administration officials, and informal advisors. So the image that they sketch is that he is absorbing things. Whatever happens to be on TV, we'll say benefit of the doubt, he's watching Fox News.
Right.
Or newspapers, and then based on what he sees and what he reads, he then does things. Which sort of, the idea there is that he is just like, I don't know, one of us or something. Like, you know, we absorb the news and we tweet about it, or we talk to a friend. He just does that with all the authority of the president. That I think is a very charitable impression of what he is doing. Because when you get into the numbers, it's not just that he's supposedly doing that, it's that he's doing a lot of that. So let's break down his official schedule by the numbers since November 7th. So right around the time of the midterm. Let's bring up this chart and you're gonna see that since then until February 1st, executive time, the ironically labeled time where he is acting least like an executive, totals 297 hours. That is like two-thirds of the total time, or close to two-thirds. You have meetings for 77 hours, lunch for 39 hours. Hypothetically, he could be working during lunch, I guess. You know, one hand on the McRib, one hand on the phone. I do, exactly, maybe he's doing that. Events, 20 minutes. I feel like that's not to scale if that's, oh, it's 38 hours. Okay, good, so that's, you know, that you get meetings, you get your events, which fulfill a political, you know, goal or whatever. He could be meeting with foreign dignitaries. He could be, you know, doing some sort of, I don't know, a bill signing or something like that. But that executive time, that is a big chunk there.
Yeah.
And
golf, is that included in executive time?
I don't know. I guess
we've seen him playing golf on the weekday.
That's true.
Often.
I think that this is the official schedule on weekdays, I think.
Okay.
So he's watching a lot of TV other than that, by the way. Let's give you an idea of how this works out on particular days. So for instance, he had 1 hour of scheduled meetings on January 18th and 7 hours of executive time. Now bear in mind, this is during the shutdown. This is when supposedly he is scrambling to put things back together. He's worried about this national emergency that it hasn't yet been declared, but it's obviously going on at the border. We face all of these challenges. The government's not even functioning. He spends 7 times as long watching TV and reading newspapers, if we are being incredibly charitable, as he does actually meeting with people like Mick Mulvaney and Steve Mnuchin during an incredibly important time where the government is shut down, people are going without their salaries and things like that. And I think that this is a great thing. I tweeted something about this yesterday. It is embarrassing. I would say that personally, it is pathetic that he worked his whole career to get into the White House. And once he gets there, he has no interest whatsoever in actually being president. But what's the alternative?
Yeah, but that's
what would he be doing with his time that would be better for the country or for progressives or for whoever?
Right. I don't know. This doesn't really freak me out.
No?
I mean, it's kind of like what I expected.
He spends 6 or 7 hours a day.
And that starts at 11. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I mean? I don't know. This is kind of what I expected. And just what you just said is kind of what essentially like people who had worked with him before knew about him were saying would happen if he were to win the presidency. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah, and the thing is,
he wasn't really interested in being president. He wanted to win.
Yeah. Well, I think one of the things that makes that a little bit more annoying is that that was true, but he was also constantly saying, if I get in, I'm not gonna have time to watch TV. I'm not gonna have time to play golf. That Obama, he was lazy. He was the one who wasn't working.
Yeah, but he was, like, not only, I'm not even talking about the things that he also was saying that turned out to be lies, but he was saying things that couldn't even, like, possibly come true.
Like what?
So, like, Mexico is gonna pay for the wall.
Yeah, that's true.
So, like, there were a list of things he was telling absolute lies. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know, like, I just kind of assumed it's all a lie.
Yeah, what I think is interesting about this is not that it's particularly surprising. Uh-huh. You know, as we said, we've known for some time that he's not really working, that he wakes up and just starts watching TV.
But he's not qualified for this. Mm-hmm. He keeps hiring people who aren't qualified.
Yeah, another reason why I think it's best that he's using his time in this way. like they just plop him down at a desk, give him some crayons, and then he cranks out a few hours. But I think what is interesting about this is I think that whether they know it or not, the way that he operates, I think, is one of the reasons that a particular sort of person in America really likes him. That he just sits around his house, mm-hmm. he eats fast food, he watches Fox News, and he screams about it. He screams at the TV, he turns his screams into tweets. Like, the people who are watching Fox News, that is the life that they're living.
Yeah.
These are retirees who are pissed off at the changing world around them. They're scared of demographic change. And then they've found their avatar, a guy who spends even more time than them watching TV, a guy who has been gifted with so much privilege in terms of money and access and now political power, who doesn't care to learn about the world around him or how government is supposed to function. He supposedly has policies he wants, he has values he wants to pursue, but doesn't care to actually put the time into doing it. He is like the embodiment of American mediocrity.
Yeah, but that's not why they like him. The dog whistles, that's it. It's nice to, like, if you feel-
That's a lot of what he's screaming, like, from Fox News.
Well, yeah, I mean, but yeah, that's it, that's it. That's why he's so popular. So it doesn't matter what he does or what he's qualified for or what he's going to do. It's the fact that he is saying things out loud that a lot of intelligent people in your personal life have been telling you that you cannot say out loud. Mm-hmm. That at the very, like, you know, we know it's there, we know you're gonna act on it, but you cannot say it out loud. And people have been shamed, not enough, but a little bit for that behavior. Now they have a leader who is like, no, let's go.
Yeah.
That's why they like him.
I think what you just described is the reason that a lot of these cults of personality around people in politics and people in media sort of come about. Like, there are people who believe awful things or crazy things, mm-hmm. and they just wanna see someone in an official context. Like, coming from a TV screen.
They're tired of being shamed for their beliefs.
Exactly. They just want someone who seems smarter or, you know, whatever, more authoritative to say the same thing. By the way, the defense of this reporting that came about when Sarah Huckabee Sanders was asked, she says, while he spends much of his average day in scheduled meetings, events, and calls, there is time to allow for a more creative environment that has helped make him the most productive president in modern history. First of all, that is how you describe a kid that you are enrolling in an arts class because he can't take, you know, normal life or whatever.
Right.
But also, the most productive, I mean, come on, he's got some executive orders, they passed a tax bill, and that is effectively it. I guess he shut down the government for the longest time in history. That's an achievement.
He keeps lying to y'all. There's
that's true. That. He's fit in a lot of time for that. Thank you very much for watching this clip from the Damage Report. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell on YouTube to get notifications of our new videos. And of course, you can catch the full Damage Report live every weekday at 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific on TYT Network on YouTube TV.